So number one is grouped notifications. As you expect, all your notifications from one app get grouped together. It can look pretty neat and organized in this sort of a stack way. And then you can tap to expand and view all of them. And then you can act on each one of them one by one if you want. And when you're done, either at the top or the bottom of the list, you can collapse them back into that little stack. So it is immensely better than before. It still is a little bit buggy, and sometimes in iMessage it wouldn't group notifications, but generally it's been working pretty well. And I still would also like to see in iOS the ability to act on notifications while they're in the notification tray without leaving them. So I do this on Android all the time, but that's probably a couple years down. There's now a new Animoji. There's a koala, there's a tiger, there's a T-Rex, and there's a ghost. And also there's tongues for all of them. There's tongue detection, kind of like Snapchat has had for a while, including the skull. Everyone gets a tongue, so cool. And then there's Memoji, which will let you create any number of your own Animoji to look exactly the way you want. But it's actually really interesting. It shows you what you've used most on your phone in the last couple hours the screen has been on, and then it lets you set limits for certain apps. So if you want to make sure you only spend 1 hour on Instagram, you can tell it to do that. And then when you try to open the app after that hour is up, it looks like this. It doesn't let you in unless you click the button that lets you in. But still, you get the point. It also shows you a really detailed breakdown of your most used apps, how many times you pick up the phone during the day, the average per hour, and which apps send you the most notifications during the course of a day, how many times you pick up your phone. It really is a wealth of information, so you can do with it works. So there's this custom shortcut to check the Apple stock price in the stocks app. So that's a two-level connection. Literally, it asks you to record any phrase you want to trigger this. So I chose show me the money. So now every time I ask Siri to show me the money, it opens the stock app and checks Apple's stock price. So you could see how this would extend out to other apps and other commands with other phrases. Now the iBooks app is now Apple Books and is sporting a new design. Not the super modern look of a lot of the other things, but that's because it's books. It's supposed to be minimally distracting. The news app is redesigned, this one with a more modern UI, and the stocks app is redesigned with this slick user interface with Apple curated news alongside the companies in the stocks. Voice memos also got an update, a new logo as well, but it's like the simplest app ever, but there you go. And then it's an augmented reality app that lets you literally look through the camera, point it at objects, and measure them. Measure how long or how tall or how much volume they have, and it's actually pretty quality. The only limitation seems to be that it's definitely better with smaller objects and with things that are closer to you, but I've tried it on a number of things around the studio at this point, and it's definitely accurate. The improvement to search in photos is much more robust, to the point where they've put a search button right there on the bottom of the app, encouraging you to use it. It reminds me actually a lot more of Google Photos now. You can swipe up in iPhone X to kill apps right away. You don't have to hold down and wait for the little red minus sign to pop up anymore. That's massively more convenient. I think they heard our feedback on that one. And it's also now harder to take accidental screenshots. It's true. So if you wake up your iPhone with the power button and the volume button at the same time, that would usually accidentally take a screenshot of your lock screen. Not anymore. So that's pretty awesome. Thank you, Apple.